Kính chào quý khán thính giả của đài VBS Canada. Kính thưa quý vị, cộng đồng người Việt tại Toronto bao gồm nhiều hội đoàn đã tổ chức lễ thượng kỳ và tưởng niệm ngày 30 tháng 4 tại Nathan Phillip Square trong khuôn viên của Tòa Thị Chính Toronto. VBS Canada xin gửi đến quý vị những hình ảnh của buổi lễ sau đây.
Gửi về cho mẹ dốc gối che xanh, xin mẹ pha hộ con dòng nước mắt đã khô cằn. Gửi về cho em chiếc nhẫn yêu thương, em bán cho đời tìm được vương viên.
Trong thành phần quan trọng có thị trưởng thành phố Toronto, ông John Tory, cùng với các nghị viên của thành phố, thượng nghị sĩ Ngô Thanh Hải, các dân biểu tỉnh bang Ontario, các dân biểu liên bang Canada. Lễ chào cờ bắt đầu với toán quốc quân kỳ của Hội Ái hữu cựu sinh viên sĩ quan trừ bị Thủ Đức tiến vào vị trí hành lễ. Sau đó là lễ chào cờ Canada, Việt Nam Cộng Hòa và phút mặc niệm.
Quốc ca Canada. Việt Nam Cộng Hòa.
The National Anthem of the Republic of Vietnam.
Sau đây là phút mặc niệm. Phút mặc niệm để tưởng nhớ các bậc tiền nhân có công dựng nước và giữ nước, để tưởng nhớ đến quân dân cán chức Việt Nam Cộng Hòa đã hy sinh bảo vệ độc lập, tự do, dân chủ cho miền Nam Việt Nam và đồng bào đã bỏ mình trên đường tìm tự do.
And now a moment of silence to pay tribute to soldiers and civilians who has sacrificed their lives for the independence, freedom, and democracy for our country. So-called re-education camps. After the fall of Saigon, after April 30th, 1975, all for the struggle for freedom and democracy.
Sau đây là nghi thức đặt vòng hoa tưởng niệm ngày Quốc khánh 30 tháng 4, ngày Thanh Trung của dân tộc Việt Nam, tưởng niệm những anh hùng vì quốc vong thân.
Round of applause for Dr. Kien Lê.
Đại diện cho ban tổ chức là bác sĩ Lê Thuần Kiên, Chủ tịch Hội Người Việt Toronto đã có diễn văn khai mạc.
Các tôn giáo, tổ chức, hội đoàn, quý cô bác, anh chị. On behalf of the Vietnamese Canadians across Ontario, the various associations across Ontario, including the Vietnamese Association of Toronto and our National Vietnamese Canadian Federation, we would like to extend our warmest and deepest appreciation to everyone for being here on this most solemn day in the year for our community. It is with absolute honor, but also with the heaviest heart, that we gather here on City Hall on this cold, somber day, and luckily sunny at the moment. Almost exactly 44 years ago, the North broke the Paris Peace Accord and invaded South Vietnam and Saigon on April 30th, 1975. Subsequently, a massive, unprecedented exodus of an estimated 2 million Vietnamese escaped the oppressive regime of Communist Vietnam, left everything behind, from ancient family ties to all possessions, just to escape and knowingly lunge forward into a terrifyingly unknown future in search of freedom and democracy. We left everything except our sacred golden flag with three red stripes.
Sau đó là bài diễn văn của thị trưởng Toronto, ông John Tory, và sau khi kết thúc, ông thị trưởng Toronto đã trao cho ban tổ chức bằng tưởng lục.
Dr. Ken Lee meant as a good friend to the Vietnamese community, and I'm here joining other good friends, and I'm so pleased to be here in the presence of Senator Ngo, of course, who there is no better friend to that community and to Canada. My long-standing friend Peter Kent, member of Parliament, and of course my colleague on City Council, Councillor Anthony Peruzza, and I welcome as well the provincial representatives who are here today. I should say at the outset that we have only one ceremonial flagpole that's up there behind us, but there are many different national days and other special occasions that take place, and I guess depending on when you get your paperwork in, it has to be done in some order or other. But in a way, I'm happy that we're here because there's more room for us here. But I think what's really important to me, and I hope to you as well, I know it's true, that we have a chance down here where there's two flagpoles to have the Canadian flag and the freedom flag flying together. And I think that is something that is very important, both in terms of the wonderful contribution and presence that you have as Vietnamese Canadians, but also as a show of the solidarity that we have for the Vietnamese community, Canada, saying that we understand the traumatic events that happened in 1975 and that we understand there remain today unresolved issues that have to do with things that are so fundamental to us in terms of freedom and human rights and respect for human rights. And so that really what I'm saying to you is I'm just happy we're here in Nathan Phillips Square in front of the City Hall, which is the place where our civic democracy resides. And it is a home to many events, some of them happy and some of them not so happy. And this one I like to look at in a way as a mix, because if there's anything happy out of this, it is the fact that we have a blessed Vietnamese Canadian community here in Toronto that have done so well and make so many contributions to the city and to the province and to the country, at the same time as we're here for an event that is solemn and very serious, namely to reflect on the events of so many years ago, but to reflect as well on the fact that there are unresolved issues today. I should just mention to you that a work has begun. Senator Ngo and myself and others, Councillor Peruzza, are working on trying to establish a community center, some place where the community can come together that it can call its own. And it takes a while to do those kinds of things because you have to sort out exactly what it's going to be and where it's going to be. But I know I'll have the active help of Councillor Peruzza in doing that, as I do already, of the Senator, because I think that this is a community that that deserves to have a place and should have a place that it can call home and come together on all kinds of occasions to celebrate and to remember. We remember the fact that 60,000 refugees, part of that 2 million that Dr. Ken referred to, came to Canada. And this was our blessing. I had the opportunity, as I was just saying to Peter Kent, to go with the then Minister of Immigration to actually greet plane loads of Vietnamese refugees arriving in Canada in Edmonton, Vancouver, Whitehorse, Yellowknife, Winnipeg, and here in Toronto. And I saw people who were quite understandably shell-shocked by the experiences they had been through, and here we are, fast forward to today, where we have a confident community that is making unbelievable contributions to the well-being of their adopted country. And while Dr. Ken Lee made reference to the fact that not much was left behind, and I understand that completely, I will say that what wasn't left behind was the decency, the heart, the enterprise, the hard work, the good citizenship that people have brought to this country, and in so doing, making such an amazing contribution. And so I hope, and I'm sure it's true, because I've got to know this community very well over time, that you have found a welcoming and safe and accepting place to call your second home. And I know that you are proud contributing Canadians, and I thank you for all that you do for the well-being of every single aspect of our wonderful city and our wonderful province and country. And so I, in conclusion, say thank you for inviting me to be part of this commemoration. It is very, very important on many of these different occasions, and these are some of the ones that are a mix of sadness and joy that we have at Nathan Phillips Square. Sad and reflective about the tragic events that have taken place in the past, but joyful at the fact that we have freedom in Canada today, and reminding us all of the duty that we have to continue to work for freedom in places where they do not enjoy those same freedoms, including today in Vietnam. As you know, one of the things that it's my privilege to do as the mayor is to issue an official proclamation of a day which you have called Journey to Freedom Day. It actually happens, as you know, on April the 30th, 2019. And so I would now ask Dr. Ken Lee to accept this, the official proclamation, the official original signed version that I hope he will either share with someone in the community, because I'm looking forward to signing and issuing one of these every single year right here in front of the City Hall and raising the flag. But I hope for this year he will accept this with the utmost of respect and affection that I have for this community and for this day, and that he will find a suitable place for it that will give a proper honor to this day. So Dr. Ken Lee, where did you go? There you are. I'll give you this.
Raise the Vietnamese Heritage Freedom Flag.
Thượng nghị sĩ Ngô Thanh Hải trong diễn văn đã nêu lên giá trị của cờ vàng ba sọc đỏ, cũng như nhấn mạnh đây là ngọn cờ của dân tộc, của cộng đồng hải ngoại, chứ không riêng cho bất cứ ai hay tổ chức nào.
Our supporter, His Worship the Mayor John Tory, and Peter Kim, representing the Conservative Party and the opposition leader and Rushier, City Councilor Anthony, and the member of the Legislative Provincial. And as you know, this event is very important to us to commemorate our shared history and pay tribute to the hundreds of thousands of Vietnamese refugees who make the journey to freedom. After the fall of Saigon, hundreds of thousands of Vietnamese people fled the communists, as we know, and made the perilous journey to Canada in search of the new beginnings. Against all odds, Canada welcomed over 120,000 Vietnamese refugees with open arms. Right now, we are around 300,000 in the out across Canada, and around 100,000 in the GTA. In raising our flag, the Canadian flag and the Vietnamese Heritage flag, is to mark this special occasion. We are once again to recognize the community, modest beginning in Canada, and to celebrate our shared values of freedom and democracy. To build a new life for our families here in Canada, as we did in the last few years, especially. I would like to express my gratitude, thanks to many, many members of the federal, provincial, and city councilors.
Đến ngày quốc khánh của chúng ta, là ngày 30 tháng 4, là ngày quốc khánh mà chúng ta đã bỏ nước ra đi. Chúng ta ngày này cũng là kỷ niệm và tưởng nhớ đến những người hàng triệu người chúng ta đã bỏ nước ra đi, trong đó có chúng ta, khỏi chế độ Cộng sản Việt Nam đàn áp, và có hơn 250.000 người đã bỏ mình trên biển cả. Chúng ta đã may mắn đã thoát khỏi, chúng ta đã đến xứ Canada này, đến xứ tự do này, chúng ta xây dựng lại cuộc đời này, và chúng ta đã thành công. Để chúng ta có những giá trị và căn bản của con người, đó là tự do, dân chủ và nhân quyền mà chúng ta không thể quên được cho nhân dân Việt Nam.
Như vậy chúng ta đã bỏ lại các tôn giáo chúng ta ở trong nước, chúng ta đã bỏ lại những nhân dân của chúng ta ở trong nước vì một lợi ích cá nhân nhỏ nhỏ, chúng ta không thể chấp nhận được. Chúng ta phải luôn luôn nhớ rằng chúng ta đã bỏ nước ra đi, chúng ta đã làm chính trị. Mà khi chúng ta làm chính trị, chúng ta phải chống Cộng sản cho đến cùng. Khi nào Cộng sản không còn nữa, chúng ta mới chấp nhận được. Xin tóm lại, tôi xin cảm ơn chính phủ liên bang, chính phủ tỉnh bang, nhất là thị xã Toronto dưới sự lãnh đạo của ông John Tory đã công nhận ngày quốc hận của chúng ta là ngày này, 30 tháng 4, là ngày mà lá cờ vàng ba sọc đỏ đã được cộng đồng Việt Nam hải ngoại không cộng sản chấp nhận. Xin cảm ơn quý vị.
Peter Kent, member of the Parliament, representative for the Andrew Scheer, opposition leader. Thank you.
Thank you and good afternoon, everyone. It's a real honor to gather in the square again with you this year, as we do on Parliament Hill in a couple of days. We gather each year for two reasons. One, of course, is to commemorate the tragedy of a terrible war and the crushing of a democracy and the beginning of a humanitarian disaster, which I observed firsthand as a journalist covering the war, and on that night of April 30th, 1975, watched as we left the American Embassy aboard helicopters, the first of the armada of boats going down the Saigon River to freedom. The other reason we meet here, of course, every year is to celebrate the courage and the determination of those who chose freedom and democracy over communism, and who made so much of the generosity of Canada and Canadians to this country, to Canadian society, over the decades since. So every time I see the flag, I see your smiling faces here as we mark the freedom, the journey to freedom, it brings back to me all of those values that our communities share and that we build upon in Canadian society. Now, it's my pleasure today to convey greetings from the Honourable Andrew Scheer, leader of the official opposition, leader of the Conservative Party of Canada. And Andrew writes, "It's my pleasure to welcome all attending today to commemorate the fifth Journey to Freedom Day. Every year on April 30th, we commemorate the exodus of Vietnamese refugees, the largest mass migration of people in the 20th century, and their acceptance in Canada after the fall of Saigon in 1975. Known as the Boat People, millions of Vietnamese people fled the tyranny of communism and left behind their beloved war-torn home in search of safety and freedom. These brave refugees," Andrew writes, "faced a perilous journey where many lost their lives to deadly storms, disease, and starvation. The courage and determination of the Vietnamese people to live in a free and democratic society deserves our highest praise." Andrew concludes by saying, "I am extremely honored that the Journey to Freedom Day Act was passed under the previous Conservative government and championed by the Honorable Senator Tan Hai Ngo, the first senator of Vietnamese descent. This National Day of Commemoration also honors Canada's compassionate response and humanitarian aid in welcoming over 120,000 Vietnamese refugees in their greatest time of need. Canada's Conservatives will always be a staunch defender of freedom, democracy, and human rights wherever these fundamental freedoms are under attack. So on behalf of Canada's Conservatives, I'm proud to celebrate the incredible contributions that Canadians of Vietnamese descent have made in building our great country and commemorate those brave boat people for their courage. Sincerely, the Honourable Andrew Scheer, Leader of Her Majesty's Official Opposition. Thank you.
Thank you, Honourable Peter Kent. And next, we would like to welcome two FPPs, Ms. Butuli Karpoji and also Tom Rakocevic, to the stage to say a few words and share their thoughts with us. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Tom Rakocevic, and I'm the NDP MPP for Humber River Black Creek, a riding that is home to many Vietnamese Canadians. As well, I'm joined by NDP MPP Butuli Karpoji of Parkdale High Park. On behalf of the provincial NDP leader, Andrea Horvath, and leader of the official opposition, I congratulate you today on the raising of your freedom flag, a symbol of enduring strength in the light of great adversity. I also want to thank my friend, Dr. Ken Lay, of the Vietnamese Association of Toronto, of whom I have learned a lot, and was in fact moved to write a story of his family and his journey here in a local newspaper. And of course, I'd like to recognize Senator Ngo for his important work on proclaiming every April 30th as the Journey to Freedom Day. And I would like to thank Mayor Tory and Councillor Anthony Peruzza for their support in making today's flag raising a reality in Toronto. The raising of the Freedom Flag, as well as April 30th, the Journey to Freedom Day, is bittersweet because it both evokes great pride, but also great sadness and remembrance of what was lost. More than 2 million Vietnamese fleeing from their ancestral home, a quarter of a million perishing at sea on that journey. And for those that remain, many executed, many more imprisoned. I am proud that in light of this terrible humanitarian crisis, our country, Canada, opened its arms and welcomed over 120,000 refugees. Some of you are here today, and I praise your strength. You have not forgotten who you are. You have taught your children and grandchildren their history. You brought your family to safety. And you helped to make Canada a great country even greater with your presence.
Thank you. And lastly, we have Councillor Anthony Peruzza coming up and saying a few thoughts to end all the distinguished guests. Thank you.
Thank you all so very much. It's indeed a pleasure to be here today on such an important day for the Vietnamese community, to be able to celebrate it with Mayor Tory, Senator Ngo, MP Kent, my friend and colleague Tom Rakocevic, and MPP Butuli. It's a bit of a surprise in that it's an impromptu opportunity to be able to say hello to many friends. But I want to take this opportunity as well to say thank you to Mayor Tory and City of Toronto Council for unanimously endorsing the bringing back of this activity to City Hall. I love the pageantry, I love the colors. The outfits today were absolutely amazing, but most importantly, it's an opportunity to bring together the community around an issue that's so very, very important to all of you. Like you, I came to this country from somewhere else. Although my journey was relatively uneventful. You know, my family went to Naples, we got on a ship, we came to Canada. They knew they were starting, all over again, a new beginning. But I've gotten to know over the years a number of you, and your stories are absolutely amazing in terms of the trials and tribulations that you went through to get to this great country of ours. In Canada, Canadian history is enriched by your amazing story. We are enriched by everything that you do.
Các quan khách đã cùng ban tổ chức chụp hình lưu niệm trước khi buổi lễ chấm dứt. Tiếp theo là phân văn nghệ với ca sĩ Thế Sơn cùng nhiều giọng ca và ban hợp ca trong cộng đồng.
Đời ta chim xa bay, nặng nề xoài đôi cánh bay, thiên đường càng xa vời quá.
Kính thưa quý khán thính giả, chương trình phóng sự cộng đồng của VBS Canada đến đây đã chấm dứt. Xin kính chào và hẹn gặp lại quý vị trong chương trình kế tiếp.
Suốt 20 năm qua, ta vẫn nhớ trước sau.